You have bested my bot. It's no easy matter, no easy feat. So here's the game. Just gonna go over this. Obviously, move one, it blundered with e5, or played an inaccurate move. I'm not sure. I don't know much about atomic opening theory. So I'm gonna kind of skip over this phase of the game. I've gotta turn down that noise a little bit. My remote's gone missing, so I'll do this manually. All right, that should dim the echo quite a bit. So I'm just gonna skip past this phase of the game because there are more interesting points that lie ahead anyhow. So yeah, white convincingly drives the attack home, rips away all of black's defenders on the king side, forces an exchange which accelerates white's attack. Very well done. Okay, so he doesn't always play the perfect move every move, but that's fine. Black is underestimating something here. I'm confused. I suppose White's idea is knight a3, bishop a6, and knight b5. Which is not the most obvious thing ever. Okay, so after some slight inaccuracies, White gets pushed back quite a bit, but does manage to get his pieces active. And okay, so we have a repetition. I thought that this evaluation bug was fixed. That should only evaluate to zero on the third repetition, not on the second. So I need to look into why that's not fixed. But that regardless, White's attack keeps going forward. He keeps trading down, getting into an endgame with a minuscule advantage. And black neglects the development of his bishop. I guess piece activity is at a prime here, and black's just failing to relocate the bishop, say, to b6, where it just has a greater scope. And like here, there's all kinds of threats that arise because of that bishop. So it's more difficult for White to develop the knight, and that's kind of weird. Why would okay? I guess there's too much counterplay if White plays c4 check. I guess. Either that or White's just better here and doesn't need to bother with c4 check. That's probably the case. And yeah, here Black has reasonable drawing chances. Or does he? How do I evaluate this endgame? No. Certainly White is for choice here. Black's king is tied to defending the B pawn, or blocking the B pawn. And White's gonna eventually mow down that pawn on g7. There's nothing Black can do to stop it. I mean, worst case, White just goes in circles with his knight until he's able to sack the knight for the pawn, and then White pushes the g pawn and zugzwangs Black. I guess Black counters by exchanging the bishop for the g pawn at some point, or for one of the pawns, Black exchanges the bishop, leaving us with a king pawn king endgame, which should be a draw with best play. So, yeah, okay, I do agree with the computer's evaluation that this would be less than plus one, because white doesn't have a forced win. White's only real chance there is if black blunders. Okay, we get into this endgame, and I'm not sure what black is doing. Other than burying his head in the sand. Wait, why is g5? Oh, I guess g5 is bad because it gives up the light squares. And it's not as if black's playing g4 to follow it. I guess control of f5 is pretty important for some reason. And yeah, there's no way black can block all these pawns. I mean, that's pretty simple. So, where was black's last slip? I mean, okay, g5 is bad because it accelerates what's going to happen eventually. Yeah, white's just going to trade his knight for the pawn and win the endgame. And that comes about much faster with the pawn on g5 than on g6. And yeah, well, it just drives it home. I suppose that blockading on g5 might have been a good try, in the hopes of getting the d pawn far advanced and trying to keep the kings together. But yeah, the king's not a very good blockader. So, likely both opening and endgame tables would aid Stockfish in playing better. Obviously openings, less obviously endgames, but I expect that if I had like six-man atomic endgame tables, that would probably help Stockfish recognize which endgames are lost earlier. Also, there's the one repetition bug. We see this position once. We see it. I mean, it's not even the same position, right? Bishop f6, rook a8, rook a7, rook a8. How is this plus zero? That makes no sense. Why is rook b7 better? I mean, how many times do we see the rook on a7? Once? Okay, we only saw it on a7 once. Yeah, this evaluation's just wrong. I don't know if it's worth bothering with, other than if that happened in a normal chess game. We might see a similar evaluation with the repetition. That would be something to look out for. Okay, but well played. I've already starred this game. I will upload it to Lee Chess and look through the chat logs or the video and see who was playing and give proper attribution. Well done. Does anybody care to do this again? It's your move. Just kidding, it's my move. Okay, now it's your move.